Johnson C. Smith University and the Duke Endowment have enjoyed a very special relationship since 1924, when James B. Duke established the Duke Endowment and included Johnson C. Smith University. Now, since then, we have had the support of about $92 million, if not more. That money has allowed us to really live and learn at our growing age, to establish programs, opportunities for faculty, staff, and students to really engage in research opportunities. So the relationship has been one of support for excellence in higher education. The support we've received from the Duke Endowment has grown to a very dramatic gift that was given this year, $5.7 million. It is the largest gift in the history of the university from any organization. That gift made a major statement, one that there is confidence in where we're going as we emerge as Charlotte's premier independent urban university, as we continue to increase our standards, and as we take calculated risks that will make for excellence. We are delighted to have that gift. A lot of people have asked, now, what are you doing with the $5.7 million? And I can answer that in three ways. First, we're able to redefine our management enrollment strategy, which is to increase standards for the university. And whenever that happens, the question becomes, well, how are you going to close the financial gap? Because if you include standards that will cause some students not to be admitted, well, how will you afford it? Well, we're the envy of colleges and universities. One president said, you are now living a dream life that you can increase standards and afford that. That gift has made that possible, and that has helped us move in our transformative efforts here. We're using some of the money to establish a Center for Applied Leadership and Community Development. We want our students to understand that there are various models of leadership in this global economy. We want them to know what they are and also to have the opportunity to practice them and to be mentored by leaders who represent these various styles of leadership. We also have a commitment to civic engagement. We want to be an urban university that has a relationship with all of the community organizations in our backyard, with the city of Charlotte. So the money has allowed us to develop a very strong platform in applied leadership and community development. And then one college that is very dear to our heart, and that is the Metropolitan College. We hear a lot about people now losing their jobs, they need to retool. Well, the Metropolitan College is an opportunity for working adults to engage in a flexible degree program, to come to campus late in the evenings on Saturdays, to take hybrid courses, online courses, and to get their degree. So again, as we transform ourselves, we have this strong support from the Duke Endowment in three strategic areas. The question is often raised, how do we balance the history and the tradition of the university with its future? And my answer is very simple. We simply have to be imaginative about our tradition. And when one is imaginative about a tradition, something happens, something is born, some event occurs that is intrinsically related to the tradition, but yet independent. We were founded, and people sort of grin or cringe at the language, to be the colored Princeton of the South. Well, we are going to be Charlotte's premier urban institution of the South. So we are imaginative about our tradition. We are not contradicting it. We are looking at its possibilities for the future, and that is the definition of a tradition. We want to be a responsible member of the Duke Endowment family. We look at Duke University, Davidson, Furman. We do not want anyone to see a difference. And so my goal is to position this university so that when people think about the sister schools within the Duke Endowment, they will see all of us achieving excellence without apology.